Hi, Madbronco here. Behind me is today's load. The truck I'll be driving is a Volvo and the load is 19 tonnes of tomatoes. We will be driving from Portree to Edinburgh, so please join me and let's get trucking. Right, hello, good morning. Thank you for joining me. As you can see, I'm in the truck already. Yes, I know, this is a bit weird, isn't it? Driving on a Saturday. But I'll explain when we get going what's happened and why I'm driving on a Saturday. Anyway, let's check the mirrors. All looks pretty good. Yeah, it is pretty early. I think it's just after 6 in the morning. Quite a pleasant morning. Had a little bit of rain by the looks of it. Bit on the windows, but it's stopped now and it's stopped by the time I did the intro, so that's all good. So I think we're getting the engine started. So we've got sat nav in the dashboard again. Cool. I think we'll get going. If you was with me yesterday when we might have to put some lights on, eh? When we came into Portree, you might remember this yard, pulling out of the same yard we pulled into. I think it's pretty much the only yard here, to be quite honest with you. And yes, we are hauling tomatoes, so we're probably hauling the tomatoes we brought in here yesterday. We're now hauling them out this morning. Down to Edinburgh. Probably going down to Edinburgh to be sold out to market or something. Anyway, so the story of why we're driving on a Saturday morning. While we're driving on a Saturday at all is because, you know, I do my driving experiences at the weekend, and if you know your UK circuits, the only circuit in Scotland is at Knockhill, and obviously that's where I want to go this weekend to do my driving experience. So that's why we're driving on a Saturday, to get down to Edinburgh. Because obviously my load Friday afternoon only got us to here, Portree, which is right up in the Highlands out to the west, and to get down to Knockhill, which is kind of halfway-ish between Glasgow and Edinburgh, from here like about 200 miles. So I didn't really fancy driving 200 miles in a hire car just to have to drive back 200 miles. Why I say I would have had to drive back 200 miles is because I did look into getting a hire car from here, and the problem is the only kind of people that hire cars from Portree is a small sort of family run local business hiring cars, and unlike the big car hire names where you can, you know, where they've got pretty much a depot office, you know, pretty much in every town, so you can drive and leave the car somewhere else opposed to bringing it back to the office that you rented it from. Unfortunately, with the people renting cars in Portree, that's not an option. You've basically got to bring the car back to where you rented it from, which of course is fair enough. Like I say, they're not some big multinational company, they're just, you know, family run company. So I would have had to come back to Portree. Which, like I say, it's a 200 mile drive, and then I'd have had to drive 200 miles back, which I didn't really fancy, to be quite honest with you. Especially when I could get a load down to Edinburgh, which is also the load we got. Wow, look at that view out across there. Nice. Yeah, you will notice we are backtracking a little bit again today to get out of Portree. But when we get down the road in a minute, we'll be hanging a right, I think it is. And we'll be going down a different way past Fort William. But as I was explaining the other day, unfortunately up here a lot of the roads, it's kind of one way in, one way out, so you have to backtrack a little bit to get out, and then if you're going somewhere else. So it seemed a bit crazy to say, oh, well, I've got to finish on a Friday and then have to drive a 400 mile round trip to get down to Knockhill and then back to Portree, when I could take this load, which obviously is seriously about the destination, because I hauled tomatoes yesterday, and I would imagine that some of them tomatoes we hauled yesterday are probably in the back here today. Like I say, to go down to Edinburgh, oh wow, look at the castle over there. Something we didn't spot on the way up, obviously because we was driving the other way. Cool. So the tomatoes, yeah, are going down to Edinburgh. So I thought, why say, oh, I've got to finish on Friday and then have to take a 400 mile round trip just because I've got to finish on Friday, when I could take this load, get myself down to Edinburgh, get paid, get my load out of Edinburgh, and be within about 50 miles of Knockhill. So I'm going to hire a car when I get to Edinburgh, and like I say, it's about 44 miles, I think it is, to Knockhill from Edinburgh. I'd much rather drive 50 miles than 200 miles. Look at this, lovely. Lovely way to start a Saturday morning. The weather's nice. Nice scenery. So that's why when I finished the video yesterday, I wasn't all, well, that's it, the weekend, blah, blah, blah. Because I knew that I'd be back on the road this morning. So I spent the evening last night in Portree. So we'll see if we can find a nice scenic rest stop like we had yesterday. And well, I think this is where the backtracking ends. Because we obviously came straight on. Oh, this is that dodgy junction, isn't it? Weird. Nobody seems to know who's got the right of way. So that's it, the backtracking's over, so it's all new. Wow, look at this. All new scenery now. So yeah, hopefully we can find a nice scenic rest stop. Won't be this one in a mile, admittedly. It's a bit too early to have the break in today. And then, like I say, my weekend. Wow, look at that. That's a view. My weekend will start this afternoon when I get to Edinburgh. I am going to take the 2 days. So I won't be driving Monday. Decided I wanted to get 2 days, try and get some catch up on some stuff. I don't know where this week's gone. I'm struggling to get my driving experience video done. It's pretty much finished. Wow, look at that. It's just, well, I don't know. Do the other video, these videos every day, driving, trying to be somewhat sociable when I go to these different places and people start talking to you, and, you know. I went to the other, what was it the other day when I went to beginning of the week, I took that excavator to Glasgow. Which was well north of Glasgow, and I hitched a lift back to the town with a couple of lads from the mine. I'll come out, we'll show you around, blah blah blah. In a lot of ways it's quite hard to say no, you know. Oh no, I'd rather go and sit in a hotel room or motel room on my own and edit a video. So yeah, kind of got a bit behind this week. So that's the story of why we're driving on a Saturday. And that's kind of the hazard, I suppose, of wanting to come somewhere so sort of rural and scenic, right up in the north of Scotland, that the loads are quite limited. You know, like that out of Portree, you know. Well, I say there's only one depot, there's two depots, isn't there? Because there's the one next to it that we drove into yesterday, thinking, oh, that's where we're going, and then realised, oh no, it's the depot next door, but still very limited on loads. Of course, when you want to go, want them to go to a very specific place. Wow, so we've made it to Fort William. Excellent, look at the old church, nice. Yeah, sometimes it can be a bit tricky when you want to go somewhere very specific. It's not as easy as you think. So. Yes, well, we've had a fair variety of loads this week. Only one real exciting out of the ordinary load, which was the excavator. The rest have been a variety of box trailers or curtain side trailers. But we did have the little short, stubby tanker the other day, that house over there. amongst the trees. Whoa. Wow, look at this up here. Bridge. So yeah, which I think we're going to go across. So yeah, we've had a little bit of variety. Wow, look at this. On the loads this week. But in some ways it's been more about the destinations this week. Like I say, I wanted to get up to the north, get up to Scotland, north of Scotland. But then you are a bit limited to the kind of loads you can get. So we've sacrificed some, the variety of loads for the destinations this week. Whoa, hello. Which I think has been really well worth it for this scenery. Wow. Not too sure about this skinny little roundabout, but some of these narrow little roads have been a bit challenging, but again, like I say, I think it's a small price to pay for the scenery we've had this week. Pretty spectacular, huh? Stops along here, if there's any. I think we've kind of, I did have a quick look because I was a bit concerned there might not be a lot of rest stops here in the middle of nowhere, and I think we may well have gone past kind of the last rest stop until we get to Glasgow, because there did seem to be a long stretch where I couldn't find a rest stop at all, and that may well be where we're at now. So unless this was the last rest stop before this, there seemed to be quite a long stretch. Well, I think this would be perfect to stop, don't you? Yeah, it's half an hour early, but it doesn't matter, it's only a petrol station, but better than nothing. We've got plenty of juice ourselves, so we don't need to fuel up. But I think we'll call this our break. Clever bright spark in the hole. Oh, well done, mate. Oh, God. We're going to have to kind of do a little bit of reversing again if I want to get into this space half decent. That'll do. Right. I don't even know what's going on here, but I'm stopping for a break, so I shall see you in about 45. Enjoy some of this scenery. See ya. I have just taken my mandatory break, as we are about 4.5 hours into the journey today. Always a welcome relief to stretch my legs, have a wee, and grab something to eat. Anyway, we are making good time today so far, and I've had my 45 minutes, so let's get back on the road. Right, okay, I'm back in the truck. I've had my 45 minutes. Very pleasant place to have a break. A lot of traffic, though. Tooting and, oh, I don't know. Anyway, let's get going, shall we? Still got a couple of 3 hours or so to get to Edinburgh. So let's get on with it, shall we? Get this done. And then I can start my weekend. I'm sure most of you lot have probably started your weekend. But obviously I've got to get to Edinburgh to start my weekend. Oh, tractor. Well, at least it's going the other way. It's not going my way. Can't really see what's coming up the road. Yeah, I have a little get myself comfy. We'll be going for a minute, will we? Unless somebody stops and lets me out, but doesn't seem like that's gonna happen. Magic. Thanks, mate. I was going to use coming in the petrol station. Cool. Wow, there's quite a traffic jam behind the old tractor. Oh, come on with the indicator, will you? Lovely, look at this lovely scenery. Very nice. Expect travelling through the Highlands of Scotland, most of this will be single file A roads today. Up and down, winding around. Better. It gives you a better opportunity to have a look at the scenery. You're not going too fast. It was buzzing past this on a motorway. You'd be like, oh, look at that. Oh, it's gone. makes it a little bit more interesting. Negotiating these little narrow roads. Well, not really narrow, are they? But normal A roads, but some of the corners and junctions were a bit challenging. Hopefully, the weather will stay nice for the rest of the weekend. Hopefully, you've got some nice weather wherever you are in the world. Just what we need. Oh well. How are we doing? Yeah, we're okay. It's a standard width container, not container, box trailer today. Refrigerated trailer. So no worries about the width. Old view. enjoy that as we toodle past at 20 miles an hour. Maybe I should just do loads in Scotland for the view. Could drive around here all day. Not too sure about all the tractors, mind, but. Restriction now, come on, somebody can overtake him. Won't be me, 20 cars back. Fancy farming them fields over there, that's pretty steep, isn't it? Ah, I've got a funny feeling I recognise this place. This was the mine we went to beginning of the week with the old excavator, and this is supposed to be Glasgow. Didn't make it to Aberdeen on this trip to Scotland, but leaves us somewhere maybe for next time. No, you're not turning left. Some people are the lucky people. Sit back, put your feet up, and settle in for 15 miles an hour. the only trouble, isn't it? Little country lanes, tractors, or any slow moving vehicle, and you're stuck. To pass the time, let's play a game of I Spy. See who can guess it. I Spy with my little I, something beginning with T. Not the most difficult I Spy in the world, eh? Trees, you say? No, not trees. There is a lot of them, admittedly. I'll give you another clue. There's only one of them, beginning with T. And it's in front of us. Yeah, that's right. Tractor. This is Glasgow, isn't it? Or outskirts of Glasgow. Back end of Glasgow, I don't know. Part of Glasgow. But we're not at Glasgow yet. We've got to wind our way round. A bit further. Behind this tractor. Have a look out the window, shall we, while we're going so slow. Oh, now it's starting to rain. Great. Skid off the road, following a tractor. So this started out so well, this journey, like this morning. Hopefully nobody will notice that I might ding the front of the truck. We're turning left by the looks of it. Hopefully tractor's turning right. Right for Glasgow, left for Edinburgh. So slow, and it's when I was going so slow that I took my eye off the ball, rubbed along the blooming barrier. Scenic here. I remember this, when we came up this way, this big old electricity substation thing there. Stop to let me out then. Got some friendly trucker you are. Everybody else is stopped. Oh wow, look at that. The old roof beam things for a building. They're called A-frame things. This is us in here. Oh, it's the old magic gates. They're just open. You never know who's opened them. How they know you're here. Right, just getting off the road first, I think. First order of the right. Let's have a look, see where we're at. Over there, okay. With a load of crates in the corner. Brilliant. Screw it around some. Try and come in from this side. And then I can look out of my window. Of course it's raining, so you can't see a lot. This rain will soon stop. The rest of my weekend off will be dry. Straightened up. That'll do, I think. enough of this one. What with the rain, tractors, skimming the barrier there. I'll have to get out and have a quick look at that in a minute. It's alright. Anyway, thank you for joining me on this Saturday. It was something different, wasn't it? Lovely scenery. Not so much on the weather now, but I would say everybody enjoy their weekend, but I'm sure most people are halfway through their weekend, so enjoy what you've got left of your weekend, and I shall enjoy my couple of days off. Like I say, I won't be driving Monday now. Decided when I was booking my loads up to take the Sunday and the Monday. So I shall see you lot on Tuesday. And who knows where we're going next. Well, I know. You'll have to wait and see. So have a good one. And I'll see you next time. Bye. Well, that's it for today. We have made it to our destination and delivered the load in one piece, so all good there. I hope you enjoyed the video and will join me next time, and of course please subscribe, like and comment. Have a nice day wherever you are, and I hope to see you again soon. Bye.